Hello children, very good day all of you. Now I'm going to start block 3 in science. Okay, so all of you take out your science textbooks and turn to page number 18. Okay, that is block 3. It is all about protecting animal habitat. Children, you already know what is a habitat, right? Habitat is a place where animals have got used to, animals have got adapted to or used to themselves to, okay, in the living, in the environment in which they live, in which they grow, in which they are born. Such places are called as habitats. So like we live in cities and we have homes, we have particular area where we have got used to, right children? In the same way, the animals also, okay, have got used to a particular kind of region where they are born, where they are grown up and all, and their body, the way their body is, okay, the body also helps them to survive, live in such a place, and it will not be able for them to live in other kind of places, okay. So they are got used to a particular kind of place, and it will be difficult for them to again adapt themselves to get used to some other kind of places. So the places of animals, to be in simple, okay children, to tell it in simple, the places where the animals live, where the animals have got used to, such places are known as habitat, okay. Even the environment, the climate, everything is very, very supportive for such animals to live in, okay. For example, you can see here the picture of the camel and a polar bear. So, if you take a camel and leave it in the cold place, okay. And if you take a polar bear and bring it and leave it in the deserts, then you know what would happen. You know, they will die. They cannot survive, okay? Camels cannot survive in the cold regions, in the cold places. And similarly, polar bears also cannot survive. They cannot live. They cannot sustain in the deserts and all, where it will be too hot. You know why? As I have already explained in my previous lesson, their body is in such a way that, yes, it will help them to live in certain or particular climatic conditions. Okay, and such animals are born in the places where they are actually got used to, and in the places where their body will survive them. Okay, yes. So, look here. You can also see here, they're telling they will be comfortably in its natural surroundings. The animal lives comfortably. That means what? Without any difficulty, without any suffocations, they live in the natural environment in a very comfortable manner. You know why? Just a recap, children. The polar bears, okay, they have thick fur on their body, just like sweaters and jackets and all we wear, okay. So their polar bears, we cannot, nobody is going to get sweaters and all for it, so that it's living in a very cold place, isn't it? So the body, on its body itself, there is a thick fur covering on its body, which will help it to survive in the very cold regions, in the cold climates also. And if you bring it to some other regions like forests and deserts and all, it will start feeling very hot and it will suffocate and it will die eventually. Okay, so look here, fishes also swim in water. You cannot take fish out of water, it will die otherwise. Okay, and in the same way, the tigers, elephants, zebras, deer, owls, rabbits, kangaroos, okay, all these animals are got used to certain climate, certain natural surroundings, okay, where they will depend for its food or water, shelter, that is the place where they live and the place where they feel safe, that is called shelter, to protect themselves from heat, sun, rain, cold, everything. Okay, they find shelter for themselves, animals, as we live inside our homes to protect ourselves from the all climatic conditions, from extreme hot or cold, whatever it is. We feel very comfortable when we are at home. Similarly, even the animals also, they find shelter for themselves, and also so that the other dangerous animal or the other big animals, which are called as predators, will not come and attack them, will not find them very easily. Okay, so the habitat provides each and every animal food, water, shelter and space to live. Okay, now you know what is the meaning of habitat. So this is all about habitat and importance of animal habitat. So why a habitat is very important for animals, you have understood, right children? Next, coming to the destruction of animal habitat. What will happen if you go and start destroying the habitats, that is the home of the animals? Okay, like for example, if somebody comes all of a sudden and if they start destroying your house, will you keep quiet? No, right children? We will not allow them to do so. We will protest against them. We will fight. We will talk. Yes? So what about the poor animals? Can they speak out for themselves? No. Can they fight? No. We will have weapons and all. We will not hesitate to kill the animals also for our needs, to satisfy our needs, to satisfy our desires, which is really wrong. We should not do so, right? The animals are poor animals. They are not disturbing us. They are not even bothering us. They are on their own, okay, without even disturbing us in their habitats. So they are not entering the cities. So let's see what will happen. What is the actual destruction of animal habitats? So how are people destroying the habitats? We are the main cause for the destruction of the habitats, children. Not only main cause, we are the only cause who are affecting for the, yes, who are affecting the destruction of the animal habitats. So in what ways people are destroying, children, the habitats and all? They are cutting the trees, and because of pollution, okay, and even because of pollution, what is happening due to extreme pollution and all, there is changes, there is variation in the climate. Okay, so why are people cutting down the trees and all? They are cutting down many trees, not one or two, many trees, to build the buildings, shops, malls, whatever. More and more are the desires of the man, okay? It is just growing and growing, and he's not at all satisfied. We are not satisfied, right children? So we need buildings, we need factories, we need good roads, and we need markets, and so on. We need furnitures, okay? For all this, what we are doing, we are cutting down the trees. We are entering the habitats of the animals, even without their permission, because they are poor animals, they cannot speak out. Yes, so what we are doing, we are cutting down the trees to construct the roads. We are taking the place of the habitats of the animals. Okay children, so trees are cut down, and not only for this, as I told, even for the furniture purpose and etc. There are so many other purposes, other needs for the humans, okay, for us. So, and we are going on cutting the trees, and we are not planting many trees. And you know what we are doing wrong? Yes, we have already destroyed so many forests, that is the habitats of the animals, children. Now so many animals are left homeless, okay? There are no homes for them, and even animals have been killed because of this. They die, okay, after a certain period of time. Because when their home is destroyed, they have got used to certain natural environment, certain natural surrounding. Okay, when that is destroyed, okay, they cannot find food, water, shelter, space. They are depending on the habitat where they have born and grown up. And now what is happening? It is all destroyed, right children? So children, in this way we are cutting down many and many trees. We are entering the forest, we are destroying the forest and all to satisfy our needs. Okay, and next is pollution. Pollution is one of the main cause, okay, that is not only destroying the animal habitats but also our health. So what kind of pollutions? There are three types of pollutions, right? The air pollution, the water pollution and land pollution. Air pollution, as you know, because of factories and the smokes coming out of factories, the vehicles and all, okay, it is out to the clean air and it is polluting the clean air. Okay, this is known as air pollution. And what about water pollution? So here, whatever the waste, the garbage and all is left from the factories and all, it is directly channelized to water bodies, okay, like whatever it is, river, ocean, seas and all, okay, here. And it is that pollution, because of this polluted waste, garbage and all, which has been what channelized from the factories, which has been put by the factories, from the houses, from the cities and all, okay, because of this pollution, the water animals, okay, they are dying. The water animals are dying, not only fishes, even other animals, because the water is getting polluted. And yes, it is converting the water into poison. It has become poisonous water. What will happen if we stay near the garbage, or if we have garbage in our home for a very long time? Then even we will also start getting diseases, right children? So we should not do like that. And you know what? Even what is land pollution? Actually, we are polluting the land bodies also. Okay, so here we are throwing the garbage here and there on the lands. We are not using the dustbins properly. So we are also destroying and cutting down the trees, and we are polluting the land, water and air. Who are affected by this? Not only humans, okay, not only people, but also the poor animals who have not done any mistakes. So children, the land bodies and water bodies and all, they are polluted to such an extent that they are killing, they are destroying the habitats of the animal, and the animals are getting affected by our acts, okay. So we should stop doing all this, right children? Okay, let us see how the climate is changed. Because of climate change of the habitats, the animals are dying and they are not surviving. Let us see. So the human activities, like as I told you, burning of fuels, okay, and even in factories and all, there is heavy smoke, there is large quantity of smoke which comes out of factories, and there are so many hundreds and thousands of factories, okay, and it is coming out, and the air is being polluted to such an extent that it cannot be replaced by clean air, because even the trees have been cut down. So trees are the one which gives us clean air, right children? It takes in carbon dioxide and it gives us oxygen. So it is purifying the air. The trees are purifying the air. And what happens when even trees are being cut down on one hand, and on the other hand, yes, we are polluting the air, water and the land. So what is happening here? Whatever in the air, the carbon dioxide level is keep on increasing, and even the other gases, poisonous gases, are increasing. And you know what, when there is no clean air and when there is no enough oxygen in the air, what will happen? The temperature starts increasing, okay, the temperature starts increasing, it rises. And you know what, when the temperature rises, what will happen? The ice caps in the very cold regions, okay, the ice caps like in the polar regions and all, the ice cap starts melting, okay. When the temperature is high, when you take out the ice out from the fridge, what will happen? It will start melting into water. And in the similar way, the ice caps are melting. And you know what? The animals which are depending on the polar regions, okay, or the animals which live in the habitats, in the cold habitats and all, their habitats are being destroyed. It's been melting. And you know what? Such animals are again living like orphans. They have no places to go. And they cannot survive. They cannot get used to other climatic conditions. And they are dying. Okay, children. So, this is how we are destroying the habitats of animals. Now, coming to effect of destroying animal habitats. So, as I already told you, okay, it is affecting so many animals. The lives of animals have been destroyed. And hence, you know what? Even the animals are feeling very difficulty in finding food, water, shelter, okay, and place to live, because all the place, the maximum place is being occupied by the humans. So what they will do, where they will go, children? The animals will start entering the cities and towns. They have already started entering the villages, the towns and the cities in search of food. Okay, and you know what? They come in search of food and water. They may get hurt or killed, okay, by the moving vehicles or by the people. They might hit the this one. We know we people are really strong and we are becoming cruel. We are just hitting the animals. We are killing the animals. It might be because of the vehicles, trains or the transports which move in the cities, about which the animals do not even have knowledge about. And yes, because these animals live in the forest, they are got used to live in forest. They are not like dogs, cows, farm animals, cats and all. They live in cities and they have got used to the city environment. But what about such animals, children, which lives in forest? They start coming and living in the towns. You know why they are coming? Yes, they are coming in search of food, water, shelter, etc. And they have been killed. They are killed by us, okay, children. And slowly, the number of animals is extincting. It is becoming low and low. It's decreasing. The number of the animal species, okay, are decreasing. Okay, and you know what? Species means certain group of animals, okay, which have some special features, physical features, in the sense their body is featured in such a way that they will get used to only particular environment and they cannot sustain in other environment, okay. So that is, such animals are known as species, and hence they are completely lost. Their numbers have kept on decreasing and now they are not at all there. So, they are not anymore on the earth. There are so many animals, okay? There are so many types of animals which were actually living during earlier days when everything was fine, when their habitats was not destroyed. But now, they have become extinct. That means they do not live anymore. We cannot find any of such species on earth anymore. Okay, they do not exist like dinosaurs. So dinosaurs lived in those days, okay, and what happened? Slowly their numbers got decreased and now they are no more on earth. And like dinosaurs, there are so many other animals, the Bengal tiger, the Indian leopard, okay, even they have been told as, declared as, okay, they have been told as endangered animals. So what is the meaning of endangered animals? That means even they are also, the numbers are decreasing in such a way that even they will also be lost and we cannot find them on earth one final day. So such animals are called as endangered animals and we have to protect them. We should not disturb them. We have to protect them, and if we can, we have to help them, okay, so that particular group of species will increase. The number of such particular group of species will increase. So such animals should be protected. They are endangered. Otherwise, we will not find Bengal tiger also one day, and even the Indian leopard one final day. They will also become extinct, children. Yes. So how to protect animal habitat? So this all is happening, right? How to protect animal habitat? we should plant more and more trees. Yes, of course, you can see in the picture itself, right? We should plant more and more trees. So because so many trees are being cut down, we should plant more trees, more plants. We have to take care of the environment, and of course we should not pollute. The main reason of the habitats getting destroyed is because of the pollution, and we should not pollute. So how we should avoid the pollution of land, children? By using the dustbins. You can see in the picture given below, okay? We have to use the dustbins, and we have to throw the garbage inside the dustbins. We should not wash, like village people will wash clothes, vessels, and all in water bodies. So they should stop doing that because it is polluting the water. And even whatever the waste and garbage from the factories and all, it should not be left to the water bodies, right, children? Which is again affecting and killing so many animals, water animals. And you know what? So the government also, it has created a wildlife sanctuary. You know what is a sanctuary? Sanctuary is a place, it is not a zoo, it is, okay, a place for animals, okay, to live in their natural environment. They feel they are living in the forest itself. So the government has created wildlife sanctuaries, and we should not enter the sanctuaries without permission, and we don't have any rights to destroy such sanctuaries. So the animals feel safe in their natural habitat, and this should be increased. The number of sanctuaries should be increased, right, children? And then, you know what? A wildlife sanctuary is a place just like the natural habitat of animals where they live safely. So they will not get to know like this is a sanctuary and all. There will be no difference between the habitat where they live in and in the sanctuary. So the government has also made some strict laws and all for people who cut down the trees for no reasons, or even for the endless desires and all, the trees and the forest have been destroyed, right? So even such people will be punished by the government. And you know, we as common people, what we can do is we have to plant more trees. We should not pollute the air. We have to use less vehicles, okay? Less usage of vehicles should be done. So for nearby distances and all, we can walk or we can cycle, okay? For each and everything, we should not take the vehicles out. And we should also, yes, take care of the trees. We should not cut down the trees, and we have to plant more and more trees so that the air pollution will decrease and the air will be clean. So we have to educate our friends and family why we should not cut trees and why we should plant more and more plants. So in such way, when we share our ideas and thoughts with our friends and families, what will happen, children? What will happen, children? It will help to save our environment, right? We can save our environment, not only our environment, but also we can help the animals to protect their habitats. Okay, children? So please read this lesson, Protecting Animal Habitats. Any doubts, you can share it in the WhatsApp group. And the words which are bold and black in color, such words, you can find the meaning of such words at the bottom of the page here, on the same page. So you can read the meaning and practice the difficult words. Anyways, I'll be going to give you dictation words and even question and answers notes and all very soon. By then, I want all of you to read this lesson and revise this lesson. Thank you so much, children. Bye.